Hi, welcome to my project Lasa.com.
Now let me discuss about the title of the process. The title of the process is OCT, that means a one class clustering tree for implementing one to many linkage data linkage. The main objective of this paper is data linkage. Data linkage is nothing but a splitting of data into many types. Normally it has been classified into two types. They are one to one data linkage and one to many data linkage. One to one is used to combine single object with the one data set with the single matching. Other type is one to many data type linkage. It's used to combine one data set with the group of objects to the other data set. So in our process, without using common entity, we are going to link the data by using one to many and one to one data linkage. This is the main objective of the process. Now let me discuss about the abstract of our process. Actually, in this paper, in the existing system, there are so many data linkages are available, but in that they are using the sharing the information or data by using the same type of entities. So in the present state, run of the find OCT in the data linkage is to match the entities from the different data sources which does not contain the common identifier. This is the main objective of our process. In that, here we are considering the one to many data linkage because to obtain the decision process based on the clustering tree. In the existing work, there is no one to many data linkage tasks which are addressed the issue among the same type of entities. In this paper, they propose four splitting criteria and two pruning methods called as pre-pruning and post-pruning methods which are used for inducing the OCT. The proposed technique is based on the one-class clustering technique. That's why we are named as the OCT, which is used to describe the objects that should be linked together. In this, we are using the algorithms are called coarse-grained Jaccard coefficient, fine-grained Jaccard coefficient, least probable intersections, maximum likelihood estimations, MLE algorithms. These are the four splitting criteria algorithms are used for constructing the OCT, and two pruning methods are used for constructing the OCT. Now let me discuss about the data flow diagram of OCT. First, we have to start our process by loading the data sets. In our process, we are using the two data sets named as the context data set and consumer data set. Actually, in this process, the expected outcome is considered as a decision model. In this, we use two data sets for constructing the OCT. It does not have a common entity for both data sets. So one is a context data set and other one is a customer data set. Decision will be based on the normal user or malicious user. This is the expected outcome of the process. First, we have to load the data set 1 and data set 2. In this, we use data set 1 as a context data set, data set 2 as a consumer data set. After load the data set, we have to pre-process the data set. If it is pre-processing takes place, means it goes to the another step. So in this, we have to create a training table from the two data sets which we taken as the input. After we take the input, we have to calculate the probability for each attribute. After we calculate the probability for each attribute, based on the probability value, we have to calculate the maximum likelihood estimation score, that is called MLE score, for every object in the data set. Based on the best MLE score, likelihood score, we have to choose the root node will be selected. After that, we have to choose the second level, third level attributes based on some thresholds level. After we choose that third level attributes or second level attributes, we are going to construct the tree. If the tree constructed means we are going to prune that process by using post pruning and pre pruning. Otherwise, we can't we apply pruning methods. After we construct the tree, we have to apply the MLE pruning methods. After apply the pruning methods, we are showing the decisions and to for two data sets which are matched successfully. The decisions will be based on a normal user or a malicious users. This is the complete data flow diagram of our process. Let me discuss about the complete demo of our process. First, you have to run home.java in a NetBeans IDE environment. Just right click and click run file. Then that home page will be opened here. After home page will be entered in that process, you must click the button enter. So our project title is Oct One Class Clustering Tree for Implementing One to Many Data Linkage. Just click the enter button. It will be redirected to the another frame. You have to choose a data set one called contacts data. Just click browse button, then choose data set folder. In that we have a contacts data.csv. Just this is a attributes and data in that and data set. Here we load the data set into the database. All the data are loaded into the database. After the loader into the database, here we view the data context data from database. So here we have attributes like time of execution and day of execution and geographical locations of the request, users role and type of request. Like that, here we are using these type of attributes in the contextual data set. After we load the contextual data sets, we have to choose a raw data set, and here we are applying the pre-processing. Symbols, unwanted symbols are converted into the null and null values are deleted. After pre-processed data set, we view the pre-processed data set. Then click next button for browsing the another data set called customer data form. So here it is a customer data. Then load the data set into the database. Here you can view the data set attributes and its data as customer type, customer's name, then customer's name, first name and last name, address, zip code and place of work and customer's type like data. These are the attributes here we use in the customer data form. Then click next button. Here we click have a raw data set. In that we have some unwanted values. Here we are going to clean the data set. Symbols are converted into the null. After convert the null, the null values will be deleted. Pre-processing successfully completed. Then after we pre-process the data set, we view the pre-processed data set. Then click next button. Here we get a combined table A relations and table B relations. This is a context data set, this is a consumer data set, and create a table for a training data set. Then click view. So by using these both type of data set, here we find another AB creation, AB table. Here we viewed here, and again click next. Total count of a tab, newly created table, then constructed tree constructed successfully. Just click view button. So in the data one tab we have a morning, then data one tab two tab we have that type of attributes, then data three, data four, data five like that. After that click next button. Here we are constructing the trees. Just like a node is a root node, value is a location of request. If the value is equal to location of request, then value is equal to Berlin, means it goes to the Hamburg Bremen. So by using these type of attributes, here we construct the tree for that process. After that click next button. If there is any no need to prune the Berlin branch, how to prune the Berman branch, no need to prune the Hamburg branch, need to successfully finish a pruning process. Then here we click the here we construct the tree for that process. After that here we view the nodes for a constructed prune tree. And then here we classify the data based on prune data. This is important attributes for making decisions. Then classify, click classify, then get class tables. If we click normal user means here we have a normal users of data. Then if you have to click malicious user means here we have a malicious decision values. Then get extract, extract normal user details, create secure server log data. Here are the details entered in the server log data. So after based upon the time execution of existing system and proposed system, here we construct the graph for proposed system and existing system. This is a complete demo of a process. Thank you for watching.